Hey everyone, and welcome to Top Think. Today, we're going to learn about 10 sleep myths that finally get debunked. Now, let's begin. Number 1, the golden rule. If sleep had a golden rule, it'd be this. Always get your full 8 hours. People act like anything more or less just guarantees that you'll be tired the next day. But is that golden rule actually true? Does everyone need exactly 8 hours of sleep? For most of us, the ideal amount falls somewhere between 7 and 9. Your exact number depends on all kinds of factors, like what time you go to bed, how tired you are, and how quickly you fall asleep. But a small percentage of people get significantly less sleep every night, not because they have insomnia, but because they need much less sleep to function. According to the National Institute of Health, some people have a rare gene that cuts their sleep demands in half. If you have this gene, you only need to sleep around 4 to 5 hours every single night. Now, most of us would feel drained trying to keep this schedule, but for these short sleepers, 5 hours is more than enough. Get your 8 hours might seem like the golden rule for sleep, but the truth is, everyone's sleep cycle is a little different. Number 2. Cheating your cycle. Even though your brain needs those 7 to 9 hours, you might still try to cheat the system. People like to cut their sleep short by an hour or even 30 minutes just to save some time, but they're hurting themselves much more than they realize. The sleep that you lose every night, it does add up. Let's say you're continuously skipping an hour of sleep. By the end of the week, you'll be an entire night short, and you'll feel less energetic and motivated because of it. So don't cheat your sleep cycle. Number 3. Sleeping at your desk. In the middle of a meeting, have you ever felt your eyelids get really heavy? You try everything not to fall asleep. You pinch your leg. You yell at yourself in your head. But no matter what you do, you fall asleep anyway. Teachers, bosses, and parents assume that you're falling asleep because you're lazy, or because you're just really, really bored. But that's not actually what's happening. Feeling bored and feeling sleepy are two very different processes in your brain. You could be sitting through the most excruciating meeting and feel wide awake. Now, on the flip side, you could fall asleep despite being completely engaged with what you're doing. Because the real problem isn't your level of interest, you're just not getting enough sleep. You're staying up too late, or you're waking up too many times during the night. Either way, your brain isn't getting enough rest, and that's why you can't keep your eyes open. Number 4. The sleeping brain. Many people think sleeping gives their brain a break. After a long, exhausting day, you want to give your brain a chance to slack off for a while. But going to bed doesn't actually put your brain to sleep. In fact, your brain is active the entire time that you're unconscious. Your body might be out of commission, but your brain still has lots of work to do. According to the National Institute of Neurological Disorders and Strokes, it has to log new memories, process your emotions, and detox your system. In other words, a good night's sleep might relax your body, but your brain is always on the clock. Number 5. The monophasic sleep cycle. Chances are you've been sleeping the same way for your entire life. You pick a time to go to bed and you pick a time to wake up, and then you sleep for the entire period in between. This kind of sleep cycle is called monophasic sleep. In other words, you're tackling your entire cycle in just one sitting. For many people, monophasic sleep makes a whole lot of sense. It's convenient for people who work full-time during the day, and it may also lower your risk of sleep deprivation. But monophasic sleep doesn't work for everyone. According to a 2013 study from the Medical Journal of Australia, about one-third of the population has trouble sleeping. Luckily, monophasic sleep isn't the only kind of sleep cycle out there. The first popular alternative is called biphasic sleep. Instead of packing all your sleep into one night, you're splitting your cycle up into smaller parts. Most of the time, that means 5 to 6 hours per night with a nap in the middle of the day. But what are the advantages of using biphasic sleep over monophasic sleep? According to a 1992 study from the Journal of Sleep Research, human sleep patterns may be naturally biphasic. In other words, centuries ago, humans most likely slept in two parts every day. But the real question is, does biphasic sleep actually work? By dividing up your sleep cycle, you can sleep deeper during those two individual periods. That's one reason why biphasic sleep, specifically napping, can improve your cognitive functions. This comes from a 2010 study from the Journal of Progress in Brain Research. They found that napping boosts memory, alertness, and focus for 1 to 3 hours after you wake up. So, how do you know if biphasic sleep is right for you? This sleep cycle is great for people who have trouble sleeping, work odd hours, or get on planes multiple times a week. You may also just get tired quickly during the day. By the afternoon, you may have trouble keeping your eyes open. Now, if that sounds like you, don't worry. A biphasic sleep cycle can give you the boost of energy you need to keep going. So, that's it, right? Can your cycle only be monophasic or biphasic? Turns out there are tons of diverse sleep cycles that work for all kinds of different people. The everyman cycle, for example, consists of 3 20-minute power naps followed by 3 to 4 hours of core sleep. Another one is called the uberman cycle, which splits your sleep into 8 short naps spread evenly throughout the day. My point here is, sleep isn't always simple. Some cycles have incredibly rigid schedules, and others are more loose and free-flowing. Even though monophasic sleep seems like the best way to go, it isn't the only option out there. Not by a long shot. Number 6. One type of insomnia. Few people understand what insomnia actually means. Most think that insomniacs just have trouble falling asleep, that they lie awake staring at the ceiling for hours on end, and some do. But according to a 2015 study in the Singapore Medical Journal, insomnia is a lot more complicated than that. For example, some insomniacs can fall asleep in minutes, but they wake up dozens of times throughout the night. Others will wake up way too early in the morning and can't fall back asleep, no matter how hard they try. While all insomniacs do struggle with their sleep, that doesn't mean that every insomniac is the same. Number 7. Falling asleep anywhere. Some people brag about how they're able to fall asleep in the weirdest places. They've knocked out in their office chair, at the dinner table, or even on the floor. But falling asleep anywhere isn't always a good thing. Your body isn't designed to fall asleep at the drop of a hat. If you're randomly falling asleep in strange places, that may mean you're not getting enough sleep. According to a 2007 study from the journal Neuropsychiatric Disease and Treatment, sleep deprivation leaves your brain feeling slow and drowsy throughout the day. While falling asleep anywhere may give you some funny stories, losing sleep can hurt you in the long run. Number 8. Aging sleep cycles. Another popular myth is that older people need less sleep. It's pretty common knowledge that they tend to wake up earlier, but there's no definitive evidence that older people don't sleep as much. While children and teenagers do require extra sleep, the length of your sleep cycle stays pretty consistent once you reach adulthood. From your 20s all the way to your 80s, your brain requires about the same amount of time each night. So even if your sleep schedule moves around a bit, the length of your cycle should stay the same throughout your life. Number 9. Warm and cozy. Everyone wants to feel warm and cozy when they climb into bed, right? But too much warmth can actually interfere with your sleep cycle. A 2012 study from the journal Sleep explains that hotter temperatures lower the efficiency of your sleep. In other words, the average person sleeps better in colder environments. Colder temperatures leave you more alert in the morning and relax the muscles related to snoring and sleep apnea. Yeah, I know it's nice to feel warm and cozy at night, but a colder room may give you the quality of sleep that you're looking for. Number 10. Never too much sleep. This myth gets thrown around all the time, but it couldn't be more untrue. Many people spend their weekends sleeping for 10 or 12 hours at a time. But there is such a thing as too much sleep, and getting too much of it can be just as bad as getting too little. This was discovered by a huge study from 2018, which was published in the journal Sleep. researchers looked at the sleep cycles of over 10,000 people. And what did they find? Getting too much sleep impacts several cognitive functions, like memory, attention, and reasoning skills. So the next time you get the chance to sleep in, just think about how you're actually affecting your brain. Hey, thank you for watching Top Think, and be sure to subscribe because more incredible content is on the way.